for at least three components here, probably more. Sidebar over here on the left. Note list and note form. So let's go ahead and create all of those real quick. Let's just start with, let's just go left to right. Start with sidebar. So in the source directory, create a new file, capital S sidebar. Capitalization matters, as you may have noticed. We're going to have to import React from React. And I'm going to make this one a stateless functional component, like Seth was talking about earlier. So the whole component is actually just a function, not a class. So const sidebar equals an arrow function. And before I forget, right now, I'm going to go ahead and export it at the bottom. Export default sidebar. Then we can just return some JSX. So I'm just going to return a paragraph that says sidebar. So back in app.js, we could import that, right? Up here underneath where we import the CSS, I'm going to say import capital S sidebar from quote dot slash. And notice how I've got this listing then. That's an extension for VS Code that is listed on the tools page on the website. I have a lot of VS Code extensions listed there. I highly recommend them. It's going to make your life a whole lot easier. This is a particularly good one. So I start typing sidebar, and I just fill it in. Now, could I have said import Heidi's Pancake Emporium from sidebar? Yes, I can. It's just like saying const Heidi's Pancake Emporium equals something. This is just my local name that I'm using to refer to it here, because that was the default export from this file. So I can call it whatever I want over here. Now that's going to confuse the heck out of us if we do that. So how about we just keep naming it sidebar? But for default imports and exports, we can give it whatever name we want locally. And having given it that name, then down here we could put it in a tag. Self-closing. Now, if I had said Heidi's House of Pancakes, I'd have to put it here too, right? Doesn't matter what the file was named. Doesn't matter what the class or function was named in the other file. Just matters what we imported it as. Does it work? Yay, sidebar. Cool. And then we had note list. Create another file. Note list camelcased.js. Import React from React. Oops, excuse me. Yeah, import React from quote React. Const note list equals arrow function. And before I forget, because I absolutely will otherwise, export default note list. Let's return some JSX. Note list. Flip over to app. Import that. Import note list from note list. And throw in our JSX. Sure enough, we don't have to refresh the page, because part of what npm start or yarn start is doing is watching for any changes that we make to those files, and it's automatically going to run its build process again and even tell the browser to refresh automatically. I know, I'm reconnecting. Claims to be reconnecting. If we weren't using Create React App, we would have to set all that up manually, all that business, well, semi-manually, and that would be kind of a pain in the neck. So it's in use. But Create React App makes that dead simple. Okay. Note list, and then we had note form, right? So again, this is in the source directory. And this one, I'll just tell you, we're going to make this a full-blown class because later we will need it to be. So we'll just save ourselves the trouble later. Import React, comma, curly brace component from React. And then instead of making a function, we'll make a class. Class note form extends component. Now, if we had not put this, if we had not imported component separately and it just said import React from React, we still could have done it. We just would have had to say React.component. But by importing component directly, we can just write component. And before I forget, export default note form. And when a component is just a function, we just have to return some JSX. When it's a class, we need a render method, and that will return some JSX. Note form. If all is well, okay, no errors yet, but we're not importing it, right? So flip over to app, import note form from note form. Oh, and then actually use it in our JSX. Note form is not defined, so I wrote this wrong. Note from up here. Note form. Let me slow down for a second. Here was my error. I didn't panic. I read it. On line 14, note form is not defined. So I know that on line 14, note form is not what I think it is, right? So why did I ever think that it should have been something? Because I imported it. So I look where I imported it and notice that I misspelled it. And now all is well. It doesn't look like much, but it's there. All right, so we split it into three components that all look awful. But I'm going to go ahead and commit that. Add sidebar, note list, and note form components.